over having constructed when asked to say this thought. I am not indebted to you. It is to be known as an outcast. Whoever is the real, the serious, or stealing, even going along the road in order to take it, he is to be known as an outcast. And this is from Sutta Nipata 119-121. Lo, those who devour the wealth of orphans wrongfully, they do but swallow fire into their bellies, and they will be exposed to burning flames. And this is from the Quran, as for the thief, both male and female, cut off their hands. It is the reward for their own deed, and an exemplary punishment from God. And this is from Quran, those who, when they take the measure from mankind, demand it full. But if they measure unto them or weigh for them, they cause them loss. And this is from Quran, these acts are included in stealing, prompting another to steal, receiving stolen goods, creating confusion, to overcharge or undertake, using smart ways and measures, and deceiving others with artificial or imitation goods. This is from Catalan. Very long, long word there. 7.27 January. We read, because what is yours is not yours, how then can you regard what is not yours as yours? And this is from Talmud, there is a Rex 2.5 for all things for the common use of all men. And God has ordained that all things should be produced, that there might be food in common for all, and that the earth should be the common possession of all. Created common right, but usurpation has transformed them into private rights. And this is from Ambrose of Milan on the duties of the clergy. Private property does not constitute for anyone to an absolute and unconditional right. No one is justified in keeping for the exclusive use what he does not need when others lack necessity. This is from Pope Paul 4:6, Popularum Progressio Christianity. Metals and natural resources are special, alpha and iron are in bracket public property, close bracket. The same as water, grass, salt. Therefore, no governor is allowed to give some men exclusive possession of them, and If he does, then he acts as Papa. This is from Muhammad Ibn Adris Ash-Shafi, 346.5 Islam. And this is on page 1019, which reads, the teachings of our true father, the Reverend Dr. Samuel Moore. Religion teaches people deny and reject everything that our bodies desire. Our body tells us to steal food when it is hungry, when heaven teaches us always to say no to that impulse. And this was given to us by the devil. What is wrong with stealing? The item you steal is the result of someone's sacrifice and service. Hence, it has public value. When you take it without paying anything for it, you negate the public value that is attained. And this is a speech given to us September 30th, 1979, and we read, the fall took place when the archangel, rather than respecting Adam and serving him, instead manipulated the situation to swindle Adam. Then he looted God's creation, looting, destroying, and swindling, followed upon hatred and deception. If you take part in any of these, you will be brought down. And this is a speech given to us June 15, 1999. Read, when using public funds, you should have a more anxious heart than I, in bracket, about using the money correctly. You should feel that taking even one penny for your personal use is a painful and amputating one of your limbs. If you are casual about public funds, you will inevitably decline. The thing will come around and bite you. You may be swindled, robbed, or killed, or even killed. And this is a speech given to us November 18th, the year 2001. Indeed, all events in history are the expansion of the individual. What means and methods have successful people used to raise to the top, to reach their goal? They take advantage of other people and or embezzle from organizations. It has been an institution throughout history. Ever since the human fall, when human beings received the blood of Satan, they unconsciously became arrogant and started using others to satisfy their own need. That has been the human history is the result of the seed sown at the fall. And this is a speech given to us August 8, 1971. And we read, suppose while walking down the street, you find a golden nugget that fell from somewhere. Do not take it for yourself. If you do, it is as if you were committing a theft. Such found money is public money. Therefore, you should not use it for yourself. Do you understand the meaning of public money? If you make an offering to the church with an ulterior motive, I, Reverend Moon, will not accept it, even if you give it to mother in bracket speaking to me, close bracket. I do not touch. Misusing public money is more fearful than taking poison. You will surely be caught and made to pay when you arrive in spirit world. And this is a given as memory by the year 10001. And now we turn to page 1020. If you value your personal property more than public property, you are violating the way of heaven. If you value your personal integrity more than public integrity, you are contrary to the way of heaven. And this is a speech given to us in November 28th, the year 1971. And read the thing that you own, your material possessions, are truly your normal. You are their temporary steward. And this is a speech given to us June 15, 1969. And we read, one of the main teachings of the Unification Church is, what is mine is yours. Yours is the nation, and the nation is the world, and the world is God, and God is mine. And this is a speech given to us June 4th, 1972, and over to Reverend Akira Ota.
Fire is a page for the 10th, 17, 1, 17, the martyrs. What it says is very quickly. Once two rabbits are affected in the human world, what possible both political, economical, cultural, and environmental problems is passed in the world of true love. Every problem can be in the world of true love, every problem can be solved. This is a profound that I am really inspired to read Father's old autobiography, and maybe everybody should read. Through that book, we learn that through Father's life is just love and forget, or giving and forget, or investing and forget. Lifestyle, and this is a true love. So, if we inherit that lifestyle, or an entire human being inherit that lifestyle, the whole political problem, or corruption, or violation, or anything else, whatever, it all comes solved. I'm just reading, that John Song, the red cover, the red book. Chong Song Yong, the book right now we're reading, is true love. They also say, that true love is the giving part of the always, we self-centered love concept is giving part is looking at losing. Or if I loving and giving or investing, I expect to return. And not return, I get anger. So, of course, if you love me, but that is self-centered concept, and it didn't work. Or Satan dominates such kind of concept as you today. So we change that culture, or change the tradition, or lifestyle. I don't care, you love me, you think about or not, especially you. That's okay, we can be. The final one, what we said is the last paragraph, which we read, 1020, 1020, the end part of Father's teaching. This is the end. the main teaching of the education church is, what is mine is yours. Yours is the nation. The nation is the world. The world is God. And God is mine. So this is very profound. Finally, so just love and forget. Somewhere, no coming just, you know, if I love my spouse, maybe spouse loves me, not to me, but somewhere else, finally God loves me, coming back from God, but it's pathway. So, we how to change the world, how to change the church, how to change the culture, it's from me. Then we all want from it, we are all one from it. So not everybody should be a unification church members, but we need to be all members, and all entire human beings. Unification is for the concept and the vision we accept for peace is coming and all justice or anything. So that's very inspired today. Thank you very much. As you know, the time of any other comments, please argue come on. If you announce your name first, I would really appreciate who is being. Anybody else?
This is Reverend Oliver. I just want to thank you for your comment.
Any other comments?
I will go back to the speech from November 20, 1997. This is back in the section of, back in the previous section. And the second paragraph of that is pretty good at the end of the section. Only based on love that loves the unlovable can we find a clear direction to overcome the intractable conflicts that plague our age. We can realize around the ideological divide between the advocate for freedom and the advocate for equality. And you know, we might wonder, like, well, where is this coming from? You know, the freedom and equality seem to be very, you know, either way, but we come at it from very different perspectives. Because if you're for freedom, because in the political dialogue, especially in America now, where we have the right wing and the left wing, I think Father is talking about that. I think Father is talking about that, where if you're looking for equality, a lot of times people are willing to use force to create equality, create the semblance of equality. Taking from people who have and giving it to people who don't have by force. And equality of outcomes. But if you're looking for freedom, then they say, oh, you know, just go and everything is free, and therefore, you just do what you do, and that's it. Therefore, you are free. And either way, it's coming from a self-centered perspective. But heavily right wing is the same thing, it is equivalent to heavily left wing. And I think therefore what Father is saying headwind because
looking at it from a perspective, from a God's perspective, and from a perspective that we are made to live for the sake of others, then naturally the people who are living in freedom and are living in prosperity are going to be willing and more than willing to serve and give and to give service and really work towards prosperity for all. And if you are in seeking equality, that by doing so, and really willingly giving, willingly sacrificing, that the entire society actually prospers. So that was my take on it.
Thank you. Your comments? Any other comments?
I'm really uplifted every morning by Father's words, and I'm beginning more and more to understand that Father's words are incredibly powerful, that they're incredibly powerful because Father has actually lived these words, lived the things he's given.
Heavenly parents, we're so thankful for these readings today about economic justice and the teachings of our Father, Reverend Sun Yang Hoon. We pray that today we can really go to our respective endeavors and places of work and to our families and inspired by your words and from all other world scriptures. We pray that we can practice true love and equality and justice. And we pray for each other's success as we are now witnessing 430 couples by ourselves. And we pray also that we can reach out to all the people that you have put in there. We pray that even with this playback that we are doing, we can share this with others. We pray that they can be inspired too, as we inspire them every day by also sharing it with other brothers and sisters and our friends, our relatives, and associates, and office mates, and we pray that they will be inspired by our Father's words. And we pray that we can even share the text that we are reading today to all the people as much as we can. And we pray that we can be even halfway around the world, as one sister in Hong Kong and even in China made a comment yesterday that they liked what we told about the Hoon Dok Hae text that we are reading. from yesterday about the equality of sexes. And we pray that more of this meeting would be always be inspired as we continue on reading about Father's words, and we pray that we can always be your instrument always, our Heavenly Parents. We pray that you bring us to people who can help us, who are centers of influence, who can bring in a lot of people and even influence a lot of people. And we pray all of this in all our names and in my name, as an Archbishop Francis C. Catalan, blessed and of family. Adieu, adieu, adieu.
Adieu, adieu. Give me some prayer, please.
I'm almost glad we're here again. We pray for each other, all the pastors here in the Mid-Atlantic area. We pray for their success always. We pray for their safety always, their protection. And we pray that we can unite always with the true family, with our true mother, now here we are, and our true Father in heaven. And all the true children and our leaders, we pray that we can continue on moving forward to really create a world of peace that is really the goal of our true parents, to bring everyone, the people here on earth and the people in the spiritual world who have gone ahead of us. We pray that we can educate them through this Hoon Dok Hae. We pray also for many people that can really learn about the divine principle so that they become also a little bit good or good people like we strive to be. We pray that we can be good people and good persons and good fathers and a good family and eventually to be your true sons and daughters of Heavenly Parents. And we pray that we can strive this every day to bring unity in our minds and body and our families and all over the world. And we pray that we can Thank you.
Thank you.